Hey guys, BugCat7 here. Okay, it is Thursday, April 4th, 2019, and I want to thank you for visiting the Stonewall Research Channel here on YouTube. Thank you very much. I really do appreciate it. All right, today for you guys, I got a video on an article from Ancient Origins magazine. Ziggy Dan, one of my subscribers, had mentioned this in one of his comments, but I do subscribe to Ancient Origins. It's an excellent online magazine. Unfortunately, it just has way too many advertisements and everything. If you want to subscribe, you got to pay for it and everything. But it's a very interesting article. Just came out on April 1st. So on April Fool's Day, it came out. But it's about this new human ancestor species that was discovered in Siberia, and it has a tail. So I don't know about you, but it's kind of repulsive. And before you start thinking it's like a long monkey tail or something like that, it's supposedly, according to the article, it's just like a little nub. But it had this tail, and it just goes to show you that the possibility of different types of humanoids with different kinds of phenotypes exists in the past. And we really don't know to the fullest extent, you know, our complete ancestry as far as, you know, what type. You got to think about it. Just, you know, only 20,000 years ago, the world looked like a different place with different kinds of animals and, you know, flora and fauna that died off with the supposed ice age. So the world looked like a totally different place. And, you know, it's almost surreal, you know, when you think about it, with all these giant animals that lived just, you know, 20,000 years ago. And when you think about Göbekli Tepe, you know, being 12,000, and the possibility of more advanced civilizations being in the past, you know, I mean, this is why the alien, you know, alternative theory comes up so much, because it's hard to imagine what that past would be. It really is, you know, given just by, you know, understanding the mainstream data. You don't have to go into science fiction. It just, the type of animals that existed, I mean, just, yeah, we understand that, you know, what they call the Stone Age. But let's say, for example, these people were reduced to caveman status, that they came from a more advanced civilization in the past, but something terrible happened, a cataclysm. And then, you know, what can you really do? You know, if you're like the surviving, you know, hence all these underground cities and everything. And, you know, people like me think that, okay, that if there was some, it's hard concept to get down, that the further you go into the past, the more advanced humans or humanoids become, or more complex, or whatever it is, because of the evidence that seems to point to a more advanced civilization being in the past. And then something terrible happened and reduced these people to like caveman status, yet they still exist in a time where you had the evidence of these, you know, more recent evidence of giant creatures on the earth and in the seas, and, you know, just something you couldn't imagine. So it seems like a whole alternative universe in some respects, in some regards, to think about it that way, if it's true, even what mainstream says. See what I'm saying? So they keep finding more and more evidence of other species of humanoid, and that's the point, you know. And, you know, we know of vestigial tails in humans that occur, and, you know, they say it's a defect, okay, and they're just talking about it here. But it says here in this, okay, And they contain these vestigial tales, okay, for however repulsive it sounds to me, but contain about 10 to 12 vertebrae. That's quite a bit, okay? Most people aren't born with a tail because the structure disappears or absorbs into the body during fetal development, forming the tailbone or coccyx. The tailbone is a triangular bone located in the lower part of the spine below the sacrum. Disappearance of the tail in the embryo takes place around in the 8th week of gestation. Although a vestigial tail disappears for most people, sometimes the tail remains due to a defect during the developmental stage. In the case of a true, quote-unquote, vestigial tail, the exact cause of this defect is unknown. Okay? So the exact cause of the defect is unknown. Well, let's say, for example, it's not that it's a defect, but it's a recessive gene. Okay? And it's not a defect. Okay? But it's recessive because they found this new human ancestor species, and it had this tail. Okay? So, you know, again, like I said, some people think like me, and, you know, this is what's responsible for all the cryptids that we know about, that there was a more advanced civilization in the past, and they had knowledge of genetic engineering. They were able to do this kind of thing, and it makes you think of maybe the island of Dr. Moreau, maybe what H.G. Wells was, you know, thinking about was in his head for just the same reasons. Who knows? But it makes you think about this, okay? And Bigfoot, and, you know, we can talk about Bigfoot later, and I want to, because I have my own ideas about what Bigfoot really is. And, you know, but you have to think about it in that way. But, you know, this is just more evidence of, you know, the possibility of different sorts of humanoids existing with different kinds of phenotypes, large, small. So if you say small, it's like people are like, yeah, okay, you know, smaller is good. But if you say bigger, they're like, no, giants. So, you know, so I don't know. It's not rational to think that way. But in any case, let me just read this short article for you because it's interesting. And they found, again, you got to keep your mind open to these things. Now, you know, this changes a lot of things. But in any case, let me read it to you. It's an April 1st article by this journalist, Johanna Gillen, in Ancient Origins magazine. A multidisciplinary and multinational team of archaeologists, anthropologists, and geneticists in Siberia have announced the sensational discovery of a new hominid species that interbred with our own species, Homo sapiens, leaving genetic traces that can be seen in living people today, spanning the Ukraine and Russia and down through Mongolia, Korea, and China. The most shocking aspect of the finding is that this species had a visible tail, an archaic remnant of its evolution from primates millions of years ago, if you believe that. Okay, apparently this person does, I guess. But maybe not. Maybe it's due to genetic engineering, you know, that somebody in the past, a more advanced civilization in the past, was toying with genetic engineering. Why not? We don't know, but it seems to point that way with the cryptoids and where certain species of plants, where even corn comes from and all these edible things, and they don't know. They're trying to figure it out, but they don't know. But it seems like it's unlikely that maize or corn would form on itself. It's dependent on some other species to help it, you know, reproduce. So that's a problem for mainstream scientists, and they've been trying to figure it out for a long time. That's the truth. That's what they say. They think they know it came from a valley in Mexico. They don't know. They're trying to figure it out, and they can't, okay? The discovery was announced by British paleoanthropologist John Bennett on the 1st of April, who stated, quote, "This could be the most significant discovery in human origins research in 100 years, exclamation point, unquote. Scientists found fragments of bone deep in a cave in Siberia in April of last year, including parts of the pelvic bone, tailbone, a femur, and lower jaw fragment. They first believed the fossils belonged to early modern humans dating back approximately 50,000 years. As Homo sapiens are known to have inhabited the same area around that time. However, DNA analysis revealed that the bones belong to a distinct species, okay, distinct species, that interbred with our species, okay? At least one that they know about. This is a newly found one. So who's to say he's not going to find like 10 new ones if they keep looking? It's not over yet, folks. That's the point. That's what it is with science. It's not so much the researchers and scientists. They're happy to say about probably this and maybe that. It's the people who read that stuff and say, well, there's the proof right there, when that's not even what the real mainstream researchers are saying. They say, we don't know, but we think this. Okay, and then other people take that and say, well, that's it, you know, that's the proof. And it's not proof. And now, you know, things like this change a lot of things, so, you know. However, DNA analysis revealed that the bones belong to a distinct species, which has now been named Homo aprilensis, after the month in which it was first found, April, I guess. And they show this picture here of a guy with a real long monkey tail, but the article doesn't say that. It illustrated depicting a human-like creature with a tail from the public domain that this girl put in the article with dope. It's not, you know, it doesn't mention that. It's a little tiny nub or something like that. It's nothing. But still something. But it's not like that. Idiots. Human ancestors with the tail. The new species also showed traces of DNA from Denisovans and Homo sapiens, indicating that the three species had interbred at some point. But the most shocking aspect of the discovery is that experts have determined that Homo aprilensis would have had a small visible tail, an example of vestigiality in which a species carries traits that have lost or all or most of their original function through evolution. Quote, although structures called vestigial often appear functionless, a vestigial structure like a tail might still retain lesser functions or develop minor new ones, unquote, Dr. Bennett explained. Modern humans have many vestigial traits, such as wisdom teeth and the appendix. The coccyx or tailbone is also an example of vestigiality and is a remnant of a lost tail. And not lost in some people, evidently, just like I showed you from that health, mainstream health article. And they showed a tailbone there. There's your tailbone. And a buddy of mine on my soccer team, my football team, for those in Europe, somebody did an illegal slide tackle on him from behind, and he fell on his tailbone and busted. Had to go to the hospital. Soccer's a deadly sport, man. All mammals have a tail at some point in their development. In humans, embryos have a tail for about 4 weeks, which measures about 1/6 the size of the embryo itself. As the embryo develops into a fetus, the tail is absorbed by the growing body, but the coccyx, or tailbone, remains. The tailbone has lost its original function in Homo sapiens in assisting balance and mobility, though it still serves some secondary functions, such as being an attachment point for muscles. Okay, there's the little tail in the embryo. I got my tail. Give me some treats. However, it's the end of the article too. However, in the case of Homo aprilensis, the developing fetus would have retained a small tail that protruded externally and remained visible after birth. Scientists have called it a vestigial feature, as they do not believe the tail served a role in balance or mobility, given its short length. Okay? It's not a long monkey tail. Quote, this is the first time ever that an archaic hominid species has been found exhibiting an external tail. It is unprecedented and completely changes what we know about human evolution, unquote, said Mr. Bennett, the guy from Britain there. Research on a new species is still in the very early stages, but the multidisciplinary team plans to release their next stage of results, which involves determining how recent the species went extinct. On first day of April next year. Happy Fool's Day. You too, honey. All right, well, that's the article from this online magazine, Ancient Origins. They also have, you know, other interesting things, but, you know, this is real research, so, I mean, what can you say about it? But it certainly opens up the possibility of, you know, other kinds of humanoids, the possibility of other kinds of humanoids existing in the past with different kinds of phenotypes, different kind of morphology, okay, that we don't know anything about, okay? And this is just one find. Like I said, they dug up every square inch of everything, and I was just reading in Chaucer Mann's book, 1491, about how a lot of what they might think are Paleo-Indian settlement areas, because of the Ice Age, and, you know, going back in, you know, further back in time, Paleo-Indian, talking about, you know, cavemen, native peoples were talking about, you know, that, you know, most of that settlement areas would be underwater now because of the rise in the water level when the Ice Age ended, and now the water levels are higher, right? So all the evidence of these people that might have traveled the coast of the Americas on either side, whoever they might have been, okay, there's no evidence. You can't find any evidence because it's all underwater. You would have to do, you know, underwater archaeological research if that was even possible. Might be buried too far deep in silt and stuff. Who knows? But they dredge up things from that, you know, from the pre-Ice Age era all the time. They've done it lots of times off the coast in the Atlantic, here on the continental shelf. So, you know, that's where you would be looking for these things, you know, way underwater there. So, in any case, guys, you know, just something to think about. You know, we often talk about these kind of issues on this channel because, you know, we talk about ancient large hominids, different kinds of, you know, phenotypes and humanoids that might have lived in the past, and all these different kinds of people, you know, maybe, again, you know, I'm not the one who said this, but somebody said this about maybe how, J.R.R. Tolkien was talking about, it's not really fiction, but, you know, took it from elements of, you know, mythology from the past. But, you know, again, you know, maybe mythology, you know, is something that's, you know, true. You never know. You know, something that we think is a joke or fiction or whatever is something true, you know? Like Biggest Thickus.
Oh, Biggest Thickus. What's funny about Biggest Thickus? Well, it's a joke name, sir. I have a very great friend in Rome called Biggest Thickus. Silence! What is all this insolence? You will find yourself in gladiator school very quickly with rotten behavior like that.
Can I go now, sir?
Richard Biggest Thickus hears of this. Wait! Take him away!
Oh, sir,
No, I want him fighting rabid, wild animals within a week.
Yes, sir. Come on, you.
I will not have my friends ridiculed by the common soldiery.
Anybody else feel like a little giggle when I mention my friend Biggest Thickus? What about you? Do you find it visible? Will I say the name? Biggus. Biggus. He has a wife, you know. You know what she's called? She's called Incontinentia. Incontinentia Buttocks.
Damn! What's it called?
Alice! Alice, had enough of this rowdy, rebel, sniggering behavior. Silence! Call it home! I'm calling the guards. Seize him! Seize him! Blow your noses and seize him!
All right, guys. So,
seize him!
Life of Brian. But, you know, maybe myths from the past aren't such a joke. And there's some people who are seriously looking at it. And look, these things come up in science, and we have to change our mind about what the picture of the past really was. Okay? All right, guys. Buttcat7 signing out. Hope you liked it. Hit the like button. Peace.